to go on to the end. With your fighting grounds, with your fight on the seas and oceans, with your fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air, we shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills, we shall never surrender.
another song off Peace of Mind for you. Is that all right? You don't mind, do you? This is the song which, I suppose, after all that rubbish on the number of the beast about 666 and all that kind of stuff and all that weirdness that went down, took me back to my school days where they used to make you go to church on Sunday, and if you didn't go to church on Sunday, a big man used to pull your pants down and give you a good thrashing with a big stick, you know. This is how they thought that they taught you that religion was really a good thing, you know what I mean? As it happens, when you go to church, you sing hymns, and occasionally they write the odd good tune. A song now, based on a hymn, actually, originally. The song's called... For a single, it's about 13 and a half minutes, this particular track. The song about an albatross.
just enough.
And a load of old seamen. Make of that what you will. This is a song called
Yeah.
as 50 living men, and either no sign of growth. But there they come, a lifeless lump. They drop down, one by one.
Thank you. I don't wanna die, I don't die. brings the beast with him, because he knows the time is short.
Let him who hath understanding reckon the number of the beast,
for it is a human.
Its number is 666.
Just what I saw.
What can I say? Absolutely amazing tonight, you're terrific. It's the best audience we've ever had in Canada anyway. In case some of you don't happen to know who my friends are up here tonight, over here on the guitar we've got Mr. Adrian Smith, yeah. Over here we got on the guitar Mr. Dave Berry, yeah. On the bass guitar here, Steve Ellis. Finally, the Joker in the pack. The man who choked Linda Lovelace and all that sort of stuff and all the usual bullshit. A very funny man, a complete idiot, a lunatic. I'll second that. Mr. Nick Overbury! Stars of the show, well, you're all sitting out there at the moment. What do you think? How are you? How are you? How are you? Run to the hills! All right, let's see this building rocking! Yes.
There's some friends of ours out here who make the whole show possible, and it's nice to see that
No, no, it does need a comb, doesn't it? It does need a bit of a brush now and again. It's nice to see that... we got a whole wardrobe up here by the end of the show. It's nice to see a rock and roll station, Q107, that actually plays rock and roll instead of playing bullshit. So, the next time anybody asks you which station to phone up or anything, I know there's another few other radio stations around to run over, but take it from me, if they don't play Iron Maiden or Twisted Sister, they're a load of shit, alright? Just being subtle about it. And secondly, we were having a quick chat backstage about the show and 15,000 people here and all the rest of it. Not only is this one of the best shows ever in Canada, it's certainly one of the best and biggest Maiden shows ever in the world, alright?
is the only way I can put it. Welcome to the Iron Maiden family in 84, really. Thank you. Good night and good luck. Take care of yourselves. Have a safe one.